So I'm here at GW Martin today in Eastleigh, and this company bought one multiplex W200Y 2.5 years ago, and as you'll see next to it, they've put a repeat order in for another machine, and I'm going to find out why from Jason here from Mazak. Jason, firstly, tell us about the multiplex machines, what they do and what they're making here.
Well, the multiplex machine to us is not a new machine in our portfolio. You know, we had the multiplex since the late 80s. I mean, there's two machines in here that are 15 years old and are still running in good order today.
They are a production machine, aren't they?
They're a true production machine. The heritage of this type of machine was traditionally from the automotive background, high volume, lots of swarf. As you can see, the gantry itself is kept enclosed within the machine. We either have a pitch feed conveyor or a rotary feed conveyor. Obviously, the rotary feed conveyor lends itself to parts that we can stack. The pitch feed conveyor lends itself to prismatic parts.
Okay, now so, what's happening in the machine though?
What so the machine itself, we've got the D3 or D2 gantry loader. You've got head one and head two. It's a true twin spindle lathe. You cannot share turrets between head one and head two. So the critical thing is that the cycle time has to be balanced between head one and head two.
So if you do get that balance right, there is no better solution, is there, than this?
There is no better solution than this. It's a rigid machine.
Richard was saying about the fact that he needed, by having these machines, it meant that he could measure parts less frequently or needed to for his customer. That comes down to, I suppose, these holding tolerance.
Yeah, well, when we first got the inquiry and we looked at the previous application, there was 100% inspection on the parts. We were looking at outfeed conveyors for inspection on these machines. What we're doing now, we're measuring 1 in 5 parts, which is driven by the customer. So this machine is proven that it's holding tolerance, rigidity, and accuracy as well, and repeatability through a stable process.
Is there any options on the gantry? Can you change the size of them? You know, are you looking at the multiplex as a machine and then the automation as an add-on that you can select options with, or is it a standard product?
No, the gantry itself, you select your automation by the number of hours you want to run unmanned. So typically, customers want to run 8 hours unmanned process. So we look at the number of parts that we can load into the gantry. We look at the cycle time. We look at the service time on the tooling as well. We maintain a stable process, which may not be really the fastest cycle time, and we look at automation of getting the part out, so the touch time for the operator is a minimum of 8 hours.
What about the efficiency? We often talk about how long and the spindle up time on machines like this. Do you measure things like that within your control?
Yeah, we've got measurements within the control that can look at the activity of the machine tool itself. It can look at cycle time, it can look at the frequency of alarms, it can look at set time, it can look at changeover time. We normally, on a machine like this, would want it to work at 90, 95% OEE.
I would imagine as well, when you're supplying a piece of kit like this, you need quite a bit of application support, don't you? How do Mazak work on that front?
Yeah, with a machine like this, you know, you're looking typically a 6-month lead time. We do have machines coming through to stock, but it's trying to choose the right machine for the right specification for the right customer and the right application. But we were fortunate enough to have a machine in our technology centre at Worcester. So again, YM UK Applications got involved with this part, along with GW Martin, the pure application support. So we did all the development work up front, pre-machine delivery. The machine came in and then we proved the process out jointly on site.